be right. And as our new normal starts looking more and more like our old normal, question is what's next? Some, like New Jersey Governor Phil Murphy, now called this a pandemic of the unvaccinated. And joining me now with the dangers that poses and how best to tackle it is Dr. Valerie Brutus at Hartford HealthCare, St. Vincent's Medical Center in Connecticut. Doctor, thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate your time.
Thank you so much for having me.
Listen, Governor Murphy, among many now who are calling this a pandemic of the unvaccinated, of course, doctors such as yourself trying to get people who have been hesitant to get a shot to actually go out, get vaccinated. What is it that you would say that could convince people who are still on the fence right now?
I would tell them that our vaccine works. We have more than 150 million Americans that have been fully vaccinated. And the side effects are minimal. Among the younger population, we also have very high number of people that have been vaccinated with very little side effects. So the vaccine definitely worked, especially with the new variants. The vaccine seems to be effective. And I would encourage everybody to protect themselves. Doctor, the danger with these two variants is that it's more contagious, but it's also associated with more complicated disease. So that's why it's crucial for us to get vaccinated as much as people as we can.
Doctor, we do keep hearing that many of the new serious cases that have led to hospitalization in the country right now have one thing in common, that they are all in people who, or nearly all in people who are unvaccinated. Have you noticed that that's been the case over at St. V's as well?
Yes, that's been the case over at St. V's. You know, the majority of people that we have are unvaccinated, and the people who are sick are also the people who are unvaccinated. So this is why we really would encourage all those who are unvaccinated, especially the ones who have any comorbidities, such as hypertension or heart disease or any other autoimmune disease, just to consider to get vaccinated. That's the best way to protect yourself and to protect others.
Doctor, where are you seeing the most hesitancy right now in terms of age group and demographic?
I think the most hesitancy seems to come from the age from 18 to 25. And some things that we think could sort of through this hesitancy is that, you know, symptoms around this age population seems to be minor. So I feel like, you know, this age group feel like, you know, well, we have minor symptoms, so why should we bother get vaccinated? And I also think there's still campaign about misinformation where people are sort of concerned about the possible side effects of the vaccine and their also efficacy with the new variants.
Doctor, I just want to get back to what we were talking about a moment ago about the Delta variant and how much more highly transmissible it is than the other variants, especially now you have people who are getting back into the city. They're commuting. They're on mass transit again. They're taking planes again for vacations this summer. Does that make getting vaccinated and factoring in that Delta variant into the mix make convincing people to get vaccinated all the more pressing right now?
I would 100% say so, because the Delta variant is about 50% more contagious than the variant that we had before, which was the Alpha variant, which was a variant that was in England. So having a variant that's more contagious and having everything opening up where people are gathering more and going to outdoor events and people not wearing masks, especially for the ones who are vaccinated, just put the population that are not vaccinated under more stress and also are more vulnerable to catch this disease.
All right, so listen, the White House, it said that it will likely fall short of the president's goal. We mentioned that a moment ago, partially vaccinating 70% of American adults by Independence Day. But again, we're only talking in that case about partially vaccinating people. We're not talking about that full inoculation, the utmost protection that the current vaccines offer. So, I mean, a lot of people are wondering just how effective the current vaccines are against Delta, because there have been some different reports about that.
There have been some different reports. In England, they published a study looking specifically at the efficacy of the Pfizer and the AstraZeneca vaccine about the Delta variant. And they reported in people who were fully vaccinated, the Pfizer seems to be about more than 80% effective. It's a little bit less effective than AstraZeneca, but still above the 80%. So we know that so far the vaccine seems to be efficient against the Delta variant. Again, the danger is that, you know, we don't want another variant to come that is, again, more contagious and also to cause more severe disease. So this is why it's crucial for people to get vaccinated as fast as they can.
Again, in terms of this pandemic of the unvaccinated now, there are now likely young adults, teens, 20-somethings, who perhaps were on the fence, maybe going to get vaccinated, but now either they or their parents are worried about these concerns over myocarditis. What would you say to them?
I would say to them that this is a very rare condition. So far, more than 80% of the people who were affected by the side effects have been discharged home with no symptoms. And, you know, it's been rest and they've been doing well. This can also happen with other disease, such as other viral disease, other infectious disease. So I don't want people to think this is only caused by vaccine, but this can also happen when people get sick by viruses. So I would tell them that the vaccine is safe. It's a very rare condition. Mm. It's been extremely monitored. The majority of people who have this are discharged home and do well and seem to have no side effects.
Doctor, hang out with us here because we're going to be back. We'll give you some more questions to field in just a few moments.